Hello guys, my name is Mohammed and welcome to my episode 4 of HTML tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to tell you and I'm going to show you how to display music inside your page. So, a lot of websites usually include music, how you can download music, how you can play music online and all of that. So I'm going to show you how you can do that inside your page. So let's get started, okay, without wasting time. So to define an audio inside your HTML, you use the audio tag, that is audio. Then the audio also have its source, like we use in the image. So we have the source. So let's get rid of this, guys. Okay. We have the source where the audio is, and we also have the controls, right? These controls tells, but audio tag have a closing audio tag, you know, but in the image it doesn't have a closing tag. That is why it is called an empty tag. So we have the audio and it also have the closing audio tag. So what this control is that when you didn't put the controls inside that place, it will definitely not show on the browser, because this control tells the browser that when she saw that audio, it translates that this is definitely an audio been put on this side. So this control allow you to control how the audio works. It input how you can touch something, or how you can pause the video, or sorry, the audio, how you can play the audio and all of that. So this control is responsible for that. So the source where the audio is. So we'll just find an audio inside my page, something like let me take this Charlie Puth attention. So we'll put the Charlie Puth inside this place. So as you can see, we have our Charlie Puth attention audio.mp3 here. So we'll take this, the name of the audio, and then put it inside the source where the audio is. So we paste the attention right there and we will good to go. Controls, audio, opening and closing tag. So you can see we have all of that. So when you are watching this video, I definitely recommend that you should be on your computer typing exactly what I'm typing, so that you'll see how it works. So we are going to save this, right? When we save it, we are going to view it. So we have view it, right? As you can see, we have the image and then the audio. So let's play the audio and see. This is how you display an audio inside your browser, or to play an audio inside your browser. What if you want to add some features to this audio? You can definitely use this. What if you want to auto play it when the user view the page? It will automatically auto play. So we use the autoplay. Oh my god, this is so simple. Autoplay. I just gonna put the autoplay after the controls and it will just autoplay. Okay, so let's save this and view the page again. And we will see what will happen. Automatically auto play it. Then there's no way to stop that video or that audio until the user pause the audio. So what if we wanted to loop after the audio finishes? We use the loop. Everything here is self-explanatory. Just audio to just autoplay to autoplay the video. Just loop to loop the video or to loop the audio. Sorry. So we use that, and then we will put it again. Do the page again. It's autoplay. Went back and start playing again. You see, the loop has worked. So that is how you can use the auto play and the loop to loop when the page has been viewed. But this autoplay, I definitely recommend that you should not use this autoplay and the loop also, but what I definitely recommend is that you should not use the autoplay, because when a user receives your site and then a video just autoplay or an audio just autoplay, the user may be angry because it will eat his data and that will not make him happy. So you should definitely not use if you want people to visit your page or your site. So we will just save it, right? And just put it like that, okay? Don't put that autoplay on your page if you want it to be viewed. So this is the end of this video. If you like this video, click on the like button. Otherwise, stay tuned for my next episode.